making this more difficult than it has to be. If you just cooperate and answer the questions, you can go home. Maybe get some sleep. How are you feeling? I know it's been a long night for you. You look like you could use some rest. Nice. Look, I know what you must be going through. Really, I do. But I could use your cooperation. That's very helpful. Thank you. I'm Detective Brannigan.
Yeah, I know. I just said that. Is there something?
Do you hear that? Please. Please. I'm sorry. Just make it stop. Please.
Go, now!
What did you do to her?
She'll be fine. It's just a memory wipe spell. Very expensive, but it works. The whole station will forget the last 24 hours and everything they saw at the Woodlands. Well, hurry up!
Thanks for bailing me out.
Certainly. We found Tweedledee chained up to a post. That was your doing, correct?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know why you detained him. Dee was at the trip trap when Snow was left at the Woodlands, so he couldn't possibly be involved in this mayhem. Bluebeard's currently interrogating him, and he hasn't said anything useful. And, Bigby, we have to tread carefully here. We can't implicate an innocent man, and people are already worried about your conduct. As of late.
He's working for somebody, and whoever it is wants him snooping around every crime scene I've looked at.
That doesn't necessarily mean they're involved in the murders. I know what you're thinking, Bigby. It's been one full night and a slice of morning, and I already miss her too. You know, I never get more homesick than when one of us dies. And now, for it to be Snow, I've never been good with these sorts of things. I just can't believe this is really happening.
Yeah. It's hard.
Our stories used to be so simple. We had a beginning, a middle, and an end. But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused. Did she, give any indication to what she was thinking? When you saw her last, I mean. I don't know why, but I'd like to know that she was... I guess fine, I suppose.
She could come off as callous sometimes, but she wasn't really. She said that she wanted to change things, make it easier for Fables to get help when they need it.
I don't know what else to say, Bigby. We have to put an end to this. It's been 2 murders in as many days. If we don't unearth our culprit, and soon, there will likely be another on our doorstep tonight.
I'll get it done.
Please, Bigby. For Miss White.
I got it.
That's not a very good answer, is it?
Come on. Just tell me what I want to know. It will make things a lot less painful for you, in theory.
Oh, were you planning on using that? I just thought you really liked rubbing your little sword.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Hello, Ichabod. Sheriff.
Bluebeard.
I was just chatting with our new friend.
You were supposed to wait for us to get back. I told you, if you want to be involved, you will do things my way. No violence!
Whatever you say, Ichabod.
Hello, Bigby.
I want answers, Dee.
Oh, goody. I thought you wanted questions, and I was having so much trouble thinking of any good ones. Though I'd settled on, how's your head?
You see what I've been dealing with? What are you going to do about this, Bigby?
Shh. Please, try to be serious, Dee. Snow White is dead.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you.
You were with me when it happened, dummy.
I still have questions for you, Dee.
Sounds like a personal problem.
This is ridiculous.
Let him work. He's got more experience with these kinds of things.
Back in the alley, you mentioned your employer. Who is it? Who are you working for?
Why? You looking to change your occupation? You'd be good at it, I think.
I'm not fucking around here, Dee. All right, Dee. Let's get to know each other.
You know, I really like spending time with you, Bigby. You're so pleasant. Let's be friends. I was kidding. I don't want to be your friend. What's that you've got? What are you gonna do with that? Fuck, Bigby. Don't make me look at that. Just put that away. Please. I don't want to see that.
Snow was murdered, Dee. She was important to me. If you know who did this, you have to tell me.
I don't know what to tell you. You're barking up the wrong tree. I don't know who did it.
Just tell me who your employer is.
I'd like to help you, but I can't. My brother and I, we got a thing about loyalty. We do our job and we keep our mouths shut. If we don't hold up our end, we don't get paid.
Your brother? Where was he last night?
I can't say. He could have been anywhere.
Take your best guess.
He didn't do it, if that's what you're thinking.
Then where is he?
No, I'm not sending you after my brother. Look, I answered your question. Can I get my stuff back now?
What did you find on her?
Oh, nothing of consequence, really.
I should be leading the interrogation.
We can't have that.
Why not?
You know why.
You always carry this much cash?
I've got a lot of laundry to do this week. What's it to you? I better get that back.
So where's your brother?
Look, mate, I'd like to help. I would, but I can't tell you where he is. Last time I saw him, we split up and I went to find Faith. I don't know where he is now, but he didn't kill anybody. Just leave him out of this.
You mentioned Faith?
Look, I went to her apartment. That's no secret. You saw me.
No, there's more to it. You said you were trying to find something.
All right, Dee. What did you want from Faith?
Sorry, I can't help you. I'm not saying any more about it. I know you enjoy my company, but I'd like to be off.
You just carry this around?
Always handy that way.
Not sure this is really working.
Let's see where this goes.
It couldn't hurt, I guess.
Look, Bigby, this isn't going to work. Don't you want to find out what happened to those girls? To Snow White?
Let me handle this. Come on, Dee. What did you want from Faith? Sweet girl like her.
Sweet? You think that girl was sweet? She was a fucking thief. Fucking sweet. Faith was plenty of things, but that ain't one of them. I mean, you know what she did for a living, right?
You still seem pretty mad about it.
Hell, I ain't bothered. Wasn't me she stole from. Nah, she took something from my boss.
Your boss?
Well, that brings me back to my first question. Who are you working for?
You're gonna get me in trouble, Bigby. I can't answer any more of your questions. I'm saving that.
This is really... What's the point of this? What are you planning to do exactly?
Here.
Yeah, all right. Wanna see a trick?
Why don't you just tell me who you're working for?
Look, you're not a bad guy. I believe Beauty on that one. But I can't give you that information. That's where I gotta draw the line.
There's no way Beauty would associate with a scumbag like you.
What's wrong with me? You're telling me I ain't pretty enough? Yeah, we're real close.
I thought this was supposed to be a murder investigation, but you're treating this guy like a fucking house guest, Bluebeard! And not getting any answers from him this way. Snow White is dead. One of us. And you're going to let this ignorant shit walk out of here in one piece. Out of my way. I'll show you how it's done!
What the fuck?
What do you think you're doing?
teaching him a lesson. Now pay attention.
Stop this right now!
You enjoying yourself?
Immensely.
What was going on down there, Bigby? Abusing a prisoner like that. I thought you could control yourself.
I thought you were dead, Snow.
And that makes it okay? I hope it was worth your time.
You really scared us. If we'd just known you weren't actually dead...
I was working on this case. After a conversation in the taxi last night, I got a call from Toad. He said his son found a body. We thought it was Faith at the time. Getting her back here wasn't easy. But hopefully we'll find something on her to help us track down the killer. Or at least to figure out who she is. If it's not Faith's body.
I should have been there, Snow.
I tried calling the business office, but there was no answer. I couldn't find you, or anyone, so I took care of it.
Snow?
What is it?
I'm glad you're not dead.
Me too. I just want to get to the bottom of this. I just feel like...
What is it?
I feel responsible, in a way. She looked just like me. And maybe that's why she was killed.
If someone wants you dead, at some point they'll realize they missed their target.
And they'll come looking for me. We just have to find out who did this. And why she was glamored to look like me. I mean, that's what it is, right? So, what's our next move?
Maybe you should lie low for a while? Until we figure out what's going on.
And what? Sit around the business office twiddling my thumbs, waiting for the big bad wolf to solve all my problems?
That's not what I meant.
Well, then what did you mean? I told you, I'm tired of sitting around. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once.
I'm not yours to lose. I'm sorry. I know it's dangerous, but I'm not helpless. I can take care of myself. I've been doing it for centuries. TJ is waiting inside. He was so freaked out last night, he wouldn't tell us much. Even now, he just stops talking altogether after a certain point. He's pretty shaken up, though, so try not to be too, you know.
Myself.
Right. TJ's over there. I don't know if you want to talk to him first or after, but let me know when you're ready to see the body. I want to be there. Bufkin, do you have a second?
Of course, Miss Snow.
Pity these can't solve murders. Well, that's appropriate. The moon. Usually this is about deception or confusion. But for me, well, who knows? I hope you can find what you're looking for. Acids. Maybe this has been harder on him than I thought. Snow's perfume. Beauty and Beast. Always putting on a show for each other. Seems like not much has changed between me and Woody. I meant what I said, Snow. I will get to the bottom of this.
Oh, that's enough. Mira, vanish!
Cancel!
What the hell are you doing?
What? I wasn't touching nothing.
What's going on?
Don't worry, no harm done. Right, Bigby?
What were you doing with the mirror, Toad?
I thought maybe I'd catch you on the shitter. I was just having a laugh. We've been waiting here a long time.
TJ. It's all right. Are you ready to talk to Mr. Wolf? It's okay.
Are you okay?
Go ahead, TJ.
I go swimming at night sometimes, in the river. I wasn't doing anything bad. I promise.
Of course you weren't.
We know you're a good kid, TJ. You're okay.
You're not in trouble. Just tell me what happened.
I was there, under the big blocks, and I heard noisy feet. And when I hear that, I'm supposed to go underwater and stay real still and quiet.
That's right, son.
Then I saw... I saw the lady!
It's okay, son. Careful, Bigby.
I wasn't.
I know.
The lady fell in. But she didn't have her head on. I thought she was gonna pull me down too. Cause she had rocks on her feet and she kept falling down in the dark parts.
Cinder blocks tied to her ankles. Is there more, TJ?
Is it true? You know when people are lying? I heard you could do that. That's why you're the sheriff.
Yeah, part of my job is being able to tell when people are lying. I'm really good at it. Is there something else you want to say?
Please, don't be mad.
What is it, TJ?
I didn't stay under the water.
What?
I know I'm supposed to, but I was scared, and I went to the top again. I couldn't help it.
I gave you very specific rules. You have to stay quiet and out of sight or bad things can happen. I told you. It's dangerous out there. If someone saw you...
Leave him alone, Toad.
He's my son. I've set boundaries for a reason.
This is a special circumstance. Leave him alone.
So you didn't stay underwater?
I don't know if anyone saw me, but someone said... Stop laughing. And then I was scared, and I went under for as long as I could.
Wait, you heard someone?
Yes.
Why didn't you tell us before?
I didn't want to be in trouble.
Did you hear anyone laughing?
No.
Do you know whose voice it was?
No.
Sheriff?
Did you hear anything else?
I don't know! I don't know! I'm sorry. After I came up again, there was no one there. And I ran home, that's all. I promise! I want to go home.
Okay. You can go.
Thank you, TJ.
Okay, son. Let's get you home.
Yeah, thanks.
Come on, then.
That went about as well as I expected. You want to go look at the body now?
In a minute.
When you're ready.
Hey, Mirror.
Hello, Bigby. Nice to see you.
What were you showing Mr. Toad and his son?
Cinderella selling shoes, Rapunzel, Rose, and of course there's you. And I can't help note that you did not rhyme. Do try to stick to the rules next time.
Yeah, I'll do that. The woodsman and I were fighting. Now I want to know where he's hiding. Well, that's helpful. Where can I find Tweedledum? That piece of scum. Thank you.
So, check out anyone who fits that profile. You might start with Bluebeard.
Right away, Miss Snow.
Are you ready to examine the body now?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness! I almost forgot.
Come on. I didn't realize. I've never seen her face before now.
Are you gonna be okay? You don't have to stay.
I want to stay. I'll be fine. It's just a little strange. The glamour is so effective, it's invasive. But just do what you need to do.
It looks just like Faith's did. Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
No. He said he wanted to run more tests. If the neck wound was the same, there might be a ribbon in her mouth, too. Anything?
Nothing. So, it's not exactly the same.
Can you close her mouth? Thanks.
She got your perfume right.
How would she know? How do you know what perfume I wear?
You can't fool this nose. Also, I saw the bottle on your desk.
Do you see that?
Could be a bruise. Rope marks.
She was tied up?
They tied cinder blocks to her ankles, so she would sink.
Oh.
Track marks.
She used Mundy drugs?
Looks that way. Pretty heavily, too. I hear they only go for the legs if they've used up the veins in their arms, or if they're trying to hide the marks. Anyway, it means it's not a perfect match to your leg, unless...
Don't be ridiculous.
Maybe she was trying to compensate with that perfume. Her fist is clenched.
So she fought back?
No marks on the knuckles.
Oh.
Maybe she was grabbing something?
Maybe. What are you doing?
Only way to find out.
Jesus, Bigby. What is it? Flowers.
Yeah.
That's weird. I don't wear a brooch like that.
Maybe it really belonged to her. Not part of the glamour.
Looks like something from the homelands. Bufkin, do you recognize these symbols?
No, nothing I've seen before.
Wait. If the glamour is supposed to make her look like me, shouldn't it be concealing things like track marks? That brooch, too. Why would it change everything else? I've never seen one this sloppy.
It might be a cheap one. just to get the job done.
The witches upstairs know what they're doing. That's why they cost so much. Unless someone is making glamours illegally?
It's not technically illegal, miss. It's not encouraged, for sure, but there aren't any laws specifically forbidding it.
So there's some sort of black market for glamours?
One would assume so. I imagine anyone with access to the proper books and training could theoretically produce a glamour.
Yet another thing to worry about. Black market or not, it's a pretty good match. Look at that. The buttons aren't exact either. There's an extra one here.
You're right. These buttons are wrong. I wonder...
What?
Snow, do you mind if I, open her coat?
Bigby, just let me do it.
Still okay?
Sorry, that took longer than expected. What have you found out? Well?
Her glamour is defective.
Oh. Defective?
We are thinking it's black market. We should really be regulating this kind of thing.
Yes.
We should keep going.
Are you wearing silk lingerie, Snow?
Why do you want to know?
I'm just trying to see if the clothes are exact.
They're not.
What is that?
She had the perfume with her. Looks like someone picked it out for her.
So, someone gave her instructions. I've seen things like this before. It's definitely magic, though witches don't usually craft objects these days.
I don't think it's wise to fool around with that. It's some kind of black market magic. Who knows what it could do? We should have it looked at. Just to make sure it isn't dangerous. Don't you think?
You may be right. One way to find out.
What?
There's something in here.
How do we open it?
I think I can figure it out. Something to do with these rings here.
A deer. What does that mean? Oh. Is that...
It's your hair.
Someone must have taken this from my apartment. I noticed it was missing, but I didn't think. This was the last picture I had of Rose and me. My sister and I don't talk much anymore. Who did this, Bigby?
She's a troll?
You gotta be kidding me.
All right, you can calm down. It's not like you haven't seen a troll before.
Who is she? That wasn't there before. Who do you think she is? I don't know many trolls, I'm afraid.
Should have left them all back in the homelands.
You don't mean that, do you?
Maybe Holly knows.
The owner of the Trip Trap? No, she looks a little... Oh, no.
What is it?
It's not Holly, it's her sister Lily. She was reported missing, but I guess it just slipped through the cracks.
We have to go tell Holly.
Right. Who knows, she might know something about this, who Lily was seeing.
Well, certainly another troll.
We should go.
You can't go out there.
Why not?
It's too dangerous. Someone tried to kill you. Bigby, you can't let her go out there with you. You'd be putting her life at risk.
Bigby is not in charge of me.
He's in charge of this investigation.
That's not the same thing.
If Snow wants to come with me, I'm not gonna stop her.
But...
We should leave now. You ready?
Yeah.
This whole thing is complete bullshit, and always has been. I mean, what's his job, really?
To keep shit from reaching the Woodlands. Jack, I don't know where they are.
You're a bar. You're supposed to have darts around.
And I normally do, but who knows where the fuck they went to after...
Come on, Holly. I need entertainment. This'll do.
Okay, I know. Just relax. I'm not here to start anything.
Okay.
Miss White, I heard you had kind of a strange morning.
It's been kind of a strange morning for everyone, I think.
Every time I see this guy, he seems to lose weight. It's amazing. It really is. He loses weight and yet somehow keeps all the muscle.
Jack.
Wolfie, my dear, how are you? Because, you know, we were just talking about you. All of us. At the bar, here.
Not too good right now.
Well, that's sad to hear. Me? Oh, I'm great, as usual.
Uh-huh.
I'm dying to hear about the body that came out of the East River this morning. It was a fable, right? Oh, everyone knows.
Tweedledee was just here.
You said it looked like Snow White.
What the hell, Crane?
Sorry.
Tweedledee said you arrested him for no earthly reason. Kept him locked in the cellar all fucking night. He said you tortured him. Which... I don't know, that seems like a breach of your legislative duties. Bigby, come on. You can't be so dumb as
Jack,
to-
find the off button, now!
What is it with you two? You and Gran are all, let's get a posse together when there's no one around, but as soon as the big bad wolf walks in, your tails go between your legs. Cat got your nerve? What happened?
What happened? I'm tired is what happened.
Tired of what?
Of trouble, Jack. I'm sick and tired of trouble. I don't want any more. So just stop revving his motor, or wait outside, or fuck the hell off. I don't care which.
Jack.
What? Bigby, look. Two fables are dead. And shit, Gren's sister...
Holly's sister.
Holly's sister has been missing for what? A few days now? And we haven't heard word one about it from anyone.
Actually, have there been any updates?
I don't know how to say this to you, Holly. The woman... we found in the river.
Who was it?
You know who it was.
Boy, I sure walked into that one.
If you say one more fucking thing, just one more thing. God fucking damn it! Of course, the dear princess, Snow fucking White, is all safe and sound.
Where were you when we reported this weeks ago, huh? Where are you when we ever fucking need you? If you'd give one ounce of a shit about her, about any of us, she might have been saved. She might have been cared for. She might have been...
I'm sorry, Holly. I'm sorry we found your sister this way, and I wish this had ended up better.
Holly.
Get the fuck out of my bar.
I just want
to... It should have been you. It should have been you, and it wasn't.
We recovered this from her personal effects. I thought you might like to have it.
I didn't know she still had this. The copper was from a dwarf mine. It's very rare and very old.
That was decent of you.
Gren.
Yeah?
Take off for a bit, would you?
Are you sure?
I don't know that much about her life. Honestly, we didn't talk often. She was lost here, in the city. She just got swept away by it.
Why were you two not talking?
It seems so fucking petty now, but I didn't want to watch it with her. I think she was off the Mundy drugs, but she was hooking to pay down debt. It ate me up to see her that way. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the Puddin' and Pie. The owner, Georgie, with all his fucking fees, it's a crock of shit. That's how they kept her under their thumb, really.
Holly, it's okay. If it's too much, we don't have to do this.
Georgie. Not the first time I've heard that name. What do you know about him?
We can just go talk to him. We've got a lead. Maybe we can take it from here?
Lily.
Thanks for everything, Holly. Is there anything we can do to...
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy, and I don't need charity.
It's not charity. It's looking out for our own.
Is she... Where is she?
She's at the business office. She's taken care of.
I'm gonna have to go down there and get her. Fuck.
Please, we can handle the funeral arrangements.
No. It's a kind of... It's a formality with trolls. We burn our dead by sunrise, or... I don't know. Some old world shit will fuck your soul up.
Of course.
Okay. Good.
Let's go down to the business office and start making the necessary preparations, all right? That club?
I'll go down there now. See what I can find out from the owner.
You were good with her. I'm impressed. Really? Thanks. It just made everything easier.